the first and pleases the Father.
Watch this perfection. Not that one.
Might be the hardest to take. When you come out of the water, I'm a believer. My heart is fleshy. Life is short with a temper, like Joe Pesci. They always come and sing your praises. Your name is.
What's up, guys? It's the introduction. We've been gone for a while. Our videos have been off, and now they're coming back on. So we're gonna update you guys real fast in a hurry. What are we doing tomorrow?
We're leaving a campsite and going to a new one.
And not just a campsite, we're going to BLM land. You know what that means? It means it's free. So we're going to go there, park. Only stipulation to that is there's no power, there's no water or nothing. So we'll do the water before we leave here. We'll fill up our water tanks. We've got 100 gallons, and we got generators and stuff like that. So we'll be secure. But we're going to head there tomorrow morning. So we're going to bring you guys with us. We'll show you what it's all about. They got dirt bike trails out there. We plan on riding and getting dirty. Who needs water anyway, right?
So. Not me.
In 1,000 feet, turn left.
Roads.
Man, these sites are terrible out here. Get the beeping to stop.
We had to go through the area. We tried to park once, so it didn't really work, so we're gonna try round two.
I got my armor rolled my tires yesterday. And it's just dirt all the way. Like the tire is like this thick all the way around, and there's dirt all the way to the rim. I don't know.
Note to self, don't armor all your tires before boondocking on BLM land.
So we're trying to find a level spot. This road has ridges. And you know what we could have done? If the spot was big enough, we probably could have just leveled the tires out. I mean, that's always a possibility, too. Here's the first spot we kind of passed. You know, we could... I wonder if we can back up right there.
Sure. Let's try it.
Are you getting a kick out? I'm going across the street. I'm not listening to you right now. Let's see what's across the street. I'm
okay.
Not done trying to drive around in the dirt, but that's like the last one if we,
Okay, there's one right by the road. So we turned left at first. Now we're going to try the right. We tried which way, left or right? Well, we tried the left. Now we're trying the right.
Yeah. Off the main road, so we're going to the right side now.
Which way is right? right?
Depends on which way you're coming, right? You're going to Joshua Tree, or you're leaving Joshua Tree. So I guess we'll just say east.
No, I don't like northeast, southwest.
I'm trying to help you here. It looks like lots of sites, but did we take the wrong road? There's another road over there.
Look at, he's shaking.
All right, I'm pulling in here.
The other one kind of circled around. I wonder if this one does the same thing.
There's another camp right here.
Oh, that's not bad. Somebody left their solar shower. That's kind of big.
That's good right here. I think I can wedge it on in here, bro. I can get my trailer back there. It would be good. I got four low.
Nice tires. I feel like we've been plugged up too long. We're not used to this.
How we can get out this predicament. I'm just gonna have to go straight back.
Okay. Dang, you look like you had switches in there.
Yeah, bro. Alright, so I'm gonna try to get it here. It would be nice to go here, but.
Yeah, because then we could use the fire pit.
We can use the fire pit anyway. We can just make our own fire pit just with a couple rocks.
Okay.
How does this look, soft or does this look flat?
This looks fine, I think.
Man, we made it.
I'm gonna get five just.
Hold on, I'm gonna put some, check out the campsite. We took our dirt bikes. We took the kids out on the dirt bikes. And we went probably, I want to say, man, it seemed like 10 miles. But it might have been shorter than that. But we went that away. Show them where we went past that last mountain. Let's see. The one over there. Yeah, way past that. I mean, like, way. Where there was no more campers. And we found a secret, y'all. Sorry, I didn't find a secret. We found the borderline to Joshua Tree National Park.
Yeah.
And it's pretty much fenced all along that mountain, all the way around the edge. But anyhow, we made it here. This is BLM land. 14 days we can camp here for free. We don't have to pay anything. How much do we pay?
What do they call that? Free
99
or something?
Hey, that's an oldie but goodie. That used to be popular, free 99. I heard that before. Yeah, it doesn't cost anything. The only problem is there's no services, so there's no power, there's no water. Fortunately, we have a toy hauler, and they built this thing knowing that this thing is going to sit out there with no services where people like to go out and ride. So we got a 100-gallon tank, poop tank, black tank, poop tank.
That's the correct term.
Yeah. That thing lasts for like 4 weeks, so we don't have to worry about that. Power, we have a generator. We run that for power. We have our gas tanks on our fifth wheel, so we got all the gas we need for the dirt bike. So we're just coming out here and ride, and I think we're going to find a secret. There's a secret to national parks. You guys didn't know. When you go to national parks ran by our government, they always leave loopholes, and we love loopholes.
Government always leaves loopholes.
Yeah. For some reason, they're kind of strict, and they're strong. But they always leave you a loophole for some reason. I don't want to.
Because they secretly like the American citizens, right?
Secretly?
They're Americans?
Maybe.
Do they secretly like us?
Maybe. What's the loophole?
Well, in the mornings, the national parks, nobody's at the gate, and they never close the gate.
It sounds so bad. What she's saying is, if you go to any national park in America, okay, they charge like $40 for a vehicle to get through the gate. But they don't tell you that's only after 8 a.m. What? So if you go before 8 a.m., they leave the gates wide open. And you just drive right through. There's no sign saying you can't go through. Stop. We come back at 8. No, they're just, the gates are open. You just drive right through. And they don't even care. We used to buy a pass. It was America the Beautiful Pass. It was like $80 for the whole year.
We thought that was good.
That's what I'm getting at. That was good. Until we found out how to get in there for free. We should tell everybody that. And what are national parks? Yellowstone, Yosemite National Park, Grand Teton. I'll put a picture up. Rocky Mountains, Black Gunnison in Colorado. We've been to all of them. We'll show you a little picture here. You still have that picture somewhere where we have a little collage of pictures where we've been to all these national parks. And these places are beautiful. I mean, if you ever travel in America, you got to hit there. It's definitely not natural. What kind of trees are those? Those are Joshua trees? Oh, those palm trees. Was not palm trees.
It says palm trees. It says palm oasis.
I've never seen palm trees look like that before. That's a Joshua tree. That's not a Joshua tree. Jogging. The heck? That's a palm tree? Dang.
If I was a homeless dog or something and I had this, I'd go in there for the night. Huh. Yeah. Probably cool. And it's probably also
water. Dude, I feel like I'm at the zoo and we're in the exhibit. Where's the... What animal's in this exhibit?
I don't know, but it's not caged. Yeah, we're in the exhibit.
We're in the exhibit.
There's birds
flying
over there.
Well, look. It's a palm tree trail. Look, people have been through there. Oh, we gotta go. We gotta go. If y'all hear something, man, y'all better run, man. I bet you if it's... What the? What is that?
You pushed the branches.
No.
Yes, you did.
No, I didn't.
Oh, no, that's
something. Go, Renee. I told you. All right, here we got tonight. Go ahead, Lacey.
We got beans. We're going to have...
We got leftovers.
Yeah.
It's going to be beans, pressure cooked beans, Mexican rice. I like cheddar cheese. She likes Swiss cheese.
We're sharing a burrito tonight.
Yeah, we're sharing a burrito. We're kind of like on a little diet.
Always. We try to be always. Okay, then this.
You know what? This is birra. What? Burrita? Burritos. I showed you guys before we had birra tacos. That's the norm where you get the tacos and that shredded beef kind of marinated in its own juices. And you dip the tacos in it inside the juice. That's kind of a thing now. Everybody's doing it. So we're going to have to change it up a little bit. We made burritos. All right, so we got a little bit of cilantro going in there. That's it for the burrito, huh?
Yep, that's it.
All right, go ahead.
All the good stuff. Rice, beans, cheese, and meat.
Okay.
On a normal basis, guys, I'd be eating this whole thing.
Me too.
But since my life has changed, I'm only eating half. She's eating the other half. I'm eating half. I would love to eat the whole thing. That's a regular burrito.
It looks like a real burrito.
Lacey, let's do the birra sauce.
Okay.
What's the birra sauce?
Birra sauce.
That's all the flavoring from the beef, marinated, pressure cooked. Okay, my mouth is watering.
Oh, and there's so much.
There's extra beef. Normally, I would eat all of that, but since I've been losing weight, I can't do it. That's going back in the refrigerator. Let me see in there. Oh, yeah, I eat that for breakfast. No, I eat that for breakfast, bro.
I know.
Cut it even, because I don't get much. Foil. So, all that's in there, huh? Oh, yeah. So, what do you do? Do you just throw that in your mouth?
No, there's an art.
There's an art?
Anything beer, there's an art to it.
All
right. Take this. You take that little corner right there.
The what? You doing it like a grilled cheese sandwich?
And you dip it. Yeah, this is like tomato soup with grilled cheese.
Let me get it.
Oh.
Take that to the head like that. How is it?
That's good.
That's good?
Mm-hmm.
Dang. All right, hold on. Here, take the camera, woman. Sit down. She showed you her bite. Let me show you my bite. Go ahead, get it close in. I've been eating this already because I had to practice. This is so good. I'm upset because I can't eat a whole burrito. I can only eat half. Here we go, birra sauce. Actually, I'm going to pull this out. Oh, look at the juice. When's the last time you went at a Mexican restaurant and you had the juice at the bottom of the burrito? People don't have that no more. Am I talking, Lacey? Oh, it's going to fall in the bowl. All of this. Oh, snap.
It's
so good. Oh, I taste the bean paste. It's pasted in my lower tongue. The rice. Curds pasted over with all the beer juice and the beer meat that's fresh. That's too much for a beer burrito, right? It's delicious. Gotta try it. Come on with it. I might just drop my burrito in the beer sauce. Oh, you're still recording? They wasn't supposed to see that. Okay, videos are. This is what I normally do. Okay. Look, check this out. No, I gotta tell you what. This is what I'm gonna really do. I gotta eat this right.
That's proper.
This is proper, Lacey, I'm telling you. Oh, this knife goes in the right hand. Just didn't turn into a beer of soup. Does this look tasty?
Muendo. Yeah.
Muendo? Does it even look tasty? Wait, I'll tell you if it's tasty. Don't ever eat Jack in a Box again. I was hungry. Hold on. This is superb.